Hey guys, so today we are going to make EOS lip balm, and I bet you guys have heard of these, but they are just this cute sphered shaped little ball of a lip balm, and you open it up and it just has like this cute sphere. Sorry if you can't see that very well, but here. Yeah, it's super cute, and yeah, so the recipe that we're doing today obviously isn't going to turn out exactly like this, but it beats going to the store, and it's just fun to
So
make.
what we're going to use this video instead of like an EOS container. You could use that too if you have an empty one. But what we're going to use are eggs. And the eggs that I got are the cutest things ever. I'm going to insert in a little picture video thing. But they are just these adorable ombre sparkly eggs. And today I'm going to use a blue one. But instead of having them clear and just boring, we're going to have a tint of color. Mostly the reason for this is because I know lots of people want to see a tinted EOS. Also, these don't have much flavor. If you do it the way that I'm going to show you, it doesn't have much scent because the beeswax overtakes all of the smell pretty much. And the beeswax just smells like honey. But when it's mixed with all the other ingredients, it just doesn't smell super good. It smells like a little bit of vanilla and beeswax and honey. So it's good, it just doesn't have a super strong smell. So by adding color, you're not just having this half-smelling moisturizing lip balm. You're going to have a tinted lip balm and a sparkly egg. So who can get better than that? Like, no one can. So I think this is going to be so fun. I really hope that you guys enjoy this video.
This is the one that I already made, and as you can see, it looks a little bit different than the EOS, but I'm going to try to mold it a little bit more like the EOS today. The ingredients you'll need are petroleum jelly, coconut oil. This is optional. You can use vanilla or any other fragrance. Beeswax, which I found at Good Earth. Olive oil. And a lipstick. I just used a lipstick that I depotted, and it's a really pretty red coral color. You'll also need tinfoil to put in the bottom of your egg and a glue gun to glue it to the bottom. Also, a pot and a jar to create a double boiler. Then you could use a plain egg because the bottom is smaller, so it's more like an EOS shape, or you could use a sparkly egg like I'm using. Then you'll need a spoon so that you can mold your lip balm, but most of the time I just use my fingers because it is messy. And also you need measuring spoons and a knife.
I'm just going to cut the little plastic thing that hooks the top and bottom of the egg together because I want to be able to hook my top easily to my bottom when I'm done. Now I'm going to take my tin foil and get about this much of it. The reason I'm doing this is because my bottom of my egg has holes, so I don't want the lipstick to fall through. So I'm just going to ball up my tin foil into a super tight ball. Now I'm just going to take my glue gun and glue the bottom of my tin foil and stick that in the bottom of my egg. Now I'm going to take smaller pieces of tinfoil and crinkle them up and glue the side of the ball of tinfoil and stick those in the side so that I can cover it up all around. Once that's done, I'm going to just push it down so that it's flat and make sure I have a little bit of egg room left. So now I'm just taking all my ingredients and putting them into my jar. And the only ingredient that I'm not going to put into my jar is lipstick because I'm going to gradually put that in as I'm cooking the ingredients. Starts in my toes and I crinkle my nose. Wherever it goes, I always know that you make me smile. Please stay for a while now. Just take your time wherever you go. The rain is falling on my window pane. We are hiding in a safer place. Undercover, staying dry. Then I'm going to cut up my beeswax into small little pieces. Some people shredded it, but I find this is so much quicker and easier to do. So I just do that until I get 3 teaspoons worth of
beeswax, and I just pack it real good into my spoon, my measuring spoon. You need to fill your pot up halfway with water, and I just turned my stove on high and put my pot on the water so it would boil fast. Now I'm just getting my lipstick, and I'm getting about that much at first, but I'm eventually going to put about the whole container in because the color is fairly light for mixing it in with all the petroleum jelly and white ingredients. Keep adding lipstick until you get the desired color and pigmentation. Like I mentioned before, I think I made a mistake with this and it didn't make enough product, so I made more product with half of the ingredients and had to add more lipstick in the second batch. My foil is not covered yet, but once my liquid is done, I poured in the lipstick until it was covered. I'm going to pour my mixture into my mold, which is my tablespoon, and I am going to put it in my freezer until it hardens completely. Now, this is after I molded it because I'm going to mold it again because this is my second batch. So I just used a toothpick to get it out of my mold because it's completely hardened, and I am just trying to soften it up and put it over my EOS. How I just put it on there in the first place was I just took it out of my mold and then just placed it on top of the tin foil. And now I'm just making it taller and adjusting it to make the perfect EOS shape. And this does get super duper messy, so make sure that your hands are clean when you're touching your lip balm. As you can see, I have it all over my fingers. But overall, I think it is definitely worth it because this product is amazing. Once you're done molding this, stick it in the freezer, and I would do this overnight.
Hey guys, so this is a new day. That's why I'm wearing something different. But I put this in the freezer overnight, and then I brought it to school. And it does get a little bit softer. So what I recommend is, of course, you can like take it to school and whatever, but when you're not using it, I would just store it in the freezer, and that way it just stays solidified and it's just like the perfect EOS texture. So here is the egg. It got a little bit of lipstick on it, as you can see, but I don't think that looks too bad. I think it's still cute and sparkly. And now to show you what it looks like. There it is. It's so pretty. It's a really pretty pink coral color. It doesn't look exactly like an EOS. I just think it looks so good. It is so moisturizing. I put it on my lips and it just like, you can feel it. You can feel it after a while. The color is really pretty. I'm wearing it right now. I'll show you the swatch of it. There it is. It's just a really pretty sheer coral pink color, and it gives you the tint, like as much color as baby lips would, which is really nice, and it's in a cute, sparkly egg. Hope that you guys enjoyed this video. I had a lot of fun making it. It is time consuming. It's a lot harder than it looks, but it's a lot easier when you're not filming. But yeah, so please comment below if you guys like this video. Please send me pictures on Instagram. I love to see your recreations, and I also might even repost them. So just Insta direct them to me, or you can hashtag DIY EOS with Allie. So I really hope that you guys try this out and have a good day. Bye!